This is Victor. I'm here with the part 7 in the painting tutorial of the Stardrake. And this time we are going to start painting the wings. So, first of all, I have to say that I prime the wings with Maccragge blue. Okay, I use this paint from Games Workshop, this spray, to do this blue prime. And now we are going to paint all the membrane in Naggaroth Purple. So the idea here is, of course, these scales and this skin will go the same as the rest of the Stardrake, and the membrane of the wings will go purple. I will try to make diffuse the purple lighter to the end of the wing and put some little sparks or stars inside of the wing. So similar to what we see on the case for the Stardrake, but instead of using reds, I will be using purples. So let's start first painting the membranes of the wings, and I will use Naggaroth Night, to do this. And to do that is, as usual, we just apply a layer. I'm using quite a big brush this time because it's quite a big surface, although it's... So I will paint this, I will do that in all these spaces between all these membranes of the wings in Naggaroth Night. So I will be doing that, okay? Not mystery here, just try to leave the blue. Even if you are dirtying the blue, it's not a problem, but it's just to apply the base color for the purple. So the same color that we apply on the back spikes of the Stardrake. Okay, as you can see, we are going to be painting that. I will be doing that and I will be back once this is done. Okay, now the Naggaroth Night is applied on this part of the inside of the wings. The next step we are going to do is we are going to apply wash. And to apply wash, I'm going to do in the next way. I will do one side of the wing and I will apply the wash in that side. I will wait until this dries and then I will do the other side. And to do this, I will go with the same brush that I use for the purple and apply the wash generously. Okay. See, because I think. I'm going to apply this wash here, and I start doing this because it's the darker part, is the maybe the dirtier part of the painting of this miniature, and I want to do this before going to. We're going to leave the wing sitting like that because I want the wash to then run to this part here where I have no the brush, leaving this part where the membrane is more open. Much lighter of wash. So we want to go fast on this. Okay. We try to keep the wing a little bit tilt always to this side. And we have to be careful with the bubbles from the wash and be sure that the bubbles disappear and don't leave strange marks on the wing. We also have to be sure that we don't leave any part wash. Okay, and this part is becoming very dark, is not a big problem, but we want to avoid the ghost blends too much into the blue part. See, and I will do, of course, I will do this side of the wing, of this wing, and the rest will be done off camera. Because it makes no sense that I do all this in camera. So you see here I think I have too much. I dry my wash, I remove part of the wash. Sorry, I dry my brush and I remove part of the wash. Here it's the same. So we are going to do now this one here. Okay. Okay. You can see we apply in all the different membranes of the wing. This one here I will do at the end. And you want to do first one side and then and after the other side. Once this side is dry or almost dry, we are going to do the other side. So we need to wait to do the other side of the wing until this is almost dry. Okay. Look the other side that I didn't did anything wrong. Here this too much. So I will remove a little bit of the wash. We double check that everything is covered. And I don't have too much accumulated here. Okay, we will wait until this dries. Let's just leave it like that, a little bit tilt to this side, to be sure that I don't want that the ink is pulling in this part here. I prefer that it's pulling in the other side. So I leave it like that. I will do the other wing, and then once this dries, I will do the other side. Okay, so let's recap a little bit. We did the wash on all the sides, okay? So this is how it's looking like after the wash, very dark. And now what we are going to do in this way, in this wing, is to do the same that we did here. So we are going to do this more vibrant violet here on the extremes, keeping the dark on this side, and make all this type of a star pattern. So this is what we are going to do in that wing. I will show you how to do it. Maybe in two or three of these wing membranes, not on all the wing, I don't think makes sense. And once, and you can imagine that I will repeat the same for all the membranes for the different parts of the wings and different sides of the wing. So the colors that I'm going to be using for this, I will use, again, Naggaroth Night, okay? Here we have Naggaroth Night. I will use Xereus Purple, Genestealer Pruple, Dechala Lilac, and White Scar. The Dechala Lilac and White Scar only for the stars. These are the colors I'm going to use now to do the blend and the lighter purple at the extreme of the wings. We are going to start applying a layer of Naggaroth Night. Okay. I will work with quite a big brush. You want to thin the paint down. So you really want to paint with thin painted, and I will do these three membranes now, the transition on these three membranes, and yeah, and the rest I will do it off camera. So the first thing we are going to do is we are going to apply it again, Naggaroth Night, almost on all the wing, on all the membrane, except try to keep this part darker. So we are going to go from here to here, keeping the dark parts, okay? Of course, this will do many, very little impact, but will give more. The Nuln Oil is quite dual color, so we'll make the color more alive. And now we are going to take Xereus Purple and we will start applying Xereus Purple here. You can see I start quite thin it, okay, and we are going to apply this. The advantage to do it quite thin is that it will blend easily. Okay. Now I take Naggaroth Night and I go over to soften the transition. As this is quite watery, we are going to go to the next one. Okay, we'll let it dry. It's too thin. We will let it dry a little bit and I will go to the next one. Yes. And see playing Naggaroth Night. You want to keep the sides with the dark color. Okay, we go with Xereus Purple. More Xereus Purple. We keep insisting with Xereus Purple. Definitely higher. Okay. I think we can go even higher. This membrane is more open. So we can go a little this. Here. This is pretty white blending what I'm doing, so I am applying the next layer without waiting that the previous one is completely dry. That way I blend them together. Okay, I'm going now to use Genestealer Purple. Oxygen still purple is quite light. And when you see that you are dragging the color that is just the first layer, the previous layer, when you see that this is happening, I will just go back to Xereus Purple, apply a little bit more and let it dry, because it means that we are just removing the paint now. So I will let it dry. So this is one of the tricky parts of the, when you're doing wet blending, you have to know when you need to stop because you're dragging the paint that is below. So I'm going to apply no Naggaroth Night on this other membrane. If you dirty a little bit the blue, it's not a problem. We are going to do the blue, clean the blue later on. The other thing I'm going to do is, you see here, I went to light to the side. I'm going to take a little bit of Naggaroth Night. And because then. Okay, Xereus Purple. A little bit more of Xereus Purple. take down Naggaroth Night. Genestealer Purple. We'll let it dry there. We are going to apply Xereus Purple here. Some of the Xereus Purple on the top. Put Naggaroth Night here on this side. Okay, and Xereus Purple now. Let's wait until these layers are dry. We are going to apply Xereus Purple now here. The other way to do these transitions is doing glazes and glazes and glazes of different purples, making a lot of small, sort of thin layers of lighter purple each time. It's up to everybody who feels more comfortable with each technique. This is the technique that I like to use. I think it's working quite well for me. You see here, I'm going too light, so I will go with Naggaroth Night. With Naggaroth Night, I no shadows purple. And as you can see, I try to keep always the same direction of the strokes, the same direction as the lines or the folds we have in these wings, because in that way we are working in the direction of the sculpt, and I think it's enhancing the sculpt, it's making the... as well is the easiest way to go in the wings, to be fair. Here on the extreme of the wing, we'll paint a little bit the edge. Okay, I will go to the first fold, to the first membrane, and now apply Genestealer Purple. Okay. It may look too bright at the beginning. This is why we are going to use Xereus Purple now. We go next to it. Xereus Purple. Genestealer Pruple. We'll let it dry. We'll go to the next membrane. Now we take Genestealer and Fenrisian Purple. Naggaroth Night now here, and I will just choose Xereus Purple to mix it a little bit. And the same here. I'm going to make this later. Okay. We are going to do this wing now. You can see this paint is not covering super well. Okay. And you want to keep it thin. You don't want really to go thick on this paint. Now we go with Xereus Purple. So this is why you need to put layers and let it dry. If not, you will put too much paint. We don't want to use the Dechala Lilac. We want to keep the Dechala Lilac to do the stars. So they will be our way to the aureole of the stars on the brighter parts. So this is what I want to avoid, to use the Dechala Lilac. Okay. And I want to keep in purple the top very dark. So this half, they divide in two different directions. Okay, and we take too much. Okay, we are going to go back to the ones that we already dry. Change now to thinner brush to have more control. I'm sorry. Xereus Purple to the Genestealer. The lighter color is always the Genestealer that I'm using here. The medium purple is the Xereus Purple, and the darker is Naggaroth Night. So. Now I mix a little bit of Xereus Purple with the Genestealer Purple to make it a little bit lighter. This is quite good. Go to the next one. Again, a little bit of mixture of Xereus Purple with Genestealer Purple. Blue next here. And now Xereus Purple. And we finish with Naggaroth Night. Okay. Okay, and we're going to do the same here. Okay. So this is how we are going to leave the wings, like that. We are going to do the rest of the wings following the same process, and once the rest of the movements, and once all is done, we will go for to do the stars. Now you can see all the wing is done. Okay, I also did here the front and the other side. I keep it darker in the inside. Okay, and I also did the inside of this one. So what we are going to do now is we are going to start doing the star pattern, and we are going to use the Dechala Lilac for that. We will start with the Dechala Lilac. Okay, and we are also going to use Genestealer Pruple. And what we are going to do is we are going to apply some white dots all over the wing, making more dots in that area and less in that. Let's go to this. So I'm going to start, for example, making so, and then when you go to the middle where I use the last highlight with Genestealer Pruple, I will use here the Dechala Lilac. Okay. And we are going to combine this also with some Genestealer Pruple. We're going to go here. Right? We're going to put the pattern. We can put also here some. So we will combine the Dechala Lilac with the Genestealer Pruple. Okay, and we are going to start doing this pattern. So I will put now the fast camera and you will see how I do three of these membranes. Thank you. can see, now I have these dots on the whole wing. And what we are going to do the next is to pass from here to what you see here, okay? Or also I did the same here and in the inside, okay? So to do that, we are going to use white, and we are going to do a small dot in the middle of the spot. So we take a thin brush, okay, let me see if I can zoom in, and we are going to do some dots, okay? So you see, I try to spot, try to add the dot in the middle of the spot that we did previously. When we have a big spot like this one, we can try to do like two brights some spots, some dots can be bigger than other. Okay. You need to be perfectly centered. And you just apply, you keep applying these dots in the wings. Okay, this is quite straightforward. So I will keep doing this in fast camera, and you can follow that. Just going slow here because I want to explain one thing. Sometimes it can happen that the white dot is too big. So in that case, we are going to use back the color we used to make the spot before, and we are going to make it smaller. For example, here there was another one that for me was too big. We can reduce this also here. Okay. So this is another thing to make the dots the size that you want. So I will keep doing the rest of the wings. I think you have seen here the temple, and I will connect back when I have put the dots in all the wings. This is how they're looking like right now, okay? And now the next step, we're going to do a wash on the scales to start preparing the scales for the next work. So to do this wash, I'm going to use Asurmen blue. Okay, you can use any dark blue wash that you want to use. And I'm going to apply this just on the scales part. So we are going to try to be careful. And apply that just on the scales, especially here, You want to be careful that you don't go into the purple. So again, I will do that. I will let it dry and I will be back once this is done. So as you can see now, the wash have dried. Okay. On both sides, so we have good definition of the scales, right? And what we are going to do now, it's I'm going to work on the blue, on this blue part. I will do a part here on camera and then the rest off camera. So what I'm going to use is the Maccragge blue, what was the base color for that. Okay, I'm going to use Maccragge blue, and I'm going to use, let me see, Calgar blue. And we are going to highlight the blue, and in some points I'm going to go even lighter, and I will use a little bit of blue. We'll do this one better. Fenrisian grey. Okay, it's a grey, but it's very bluish. So we are going to use the tail brush. This is, and I'm going to start working here. Okay, let's work here, for example. So we're going to work on the edge. I'm going with the brush quite flat. Okay, we are going to do some highlights on these parts. We highlight quite a lot this, and we go like that. Okay. Then when we arrive to these things here, we are going to play a little bit more, leaving the, so something like that. Okay. Why I have Maccragge blue? Because in case I go a little bit to the side or I deviate from the point that when I want to do the highlight, I will use Maccragge blue to make this thinner. For example, here, if I find it's too thick, I go with Maccragge blue and I touch the side. Okay. So I will be doing that. Okay, and then here we are going to blend a little bit. You can see I blend directly on the miniature to have something transition more softer. Then where we are going to use the lighter color is just to make some right points on the thicker parts. Right, we're going to touch here, we're going to touch here. Okay. Of course, we will need to blend it a little bit to glaze it with the previous blue. So you can see we go and we use the, not the other blue, and we go in the opposite direction. So in that way, so we are going to do all around here. So this part we are going to do it all with Calgar blue, the light, the mid-tone. Okay. Same on the other side. Something like that, and then with the Fenrisian Grey, we just touch the very base. Like an edge highlight, just to pop up where the nail will go in black. Okay. Most of the other parts, this is I'm here in the, on the tutorial of the wing. Of course, I will show what is new for the wing, the scales, the nails, and all these things. I will do them off camera, and if you need more details, you can go to the previous tutorials. Because I will follow exactly the same process. For example, for the scales, I will follow the same process that I use. The same process I use for the scales of the back. So it's not going to be different. The same for the purple scales, I'm going to use the same that I use for the spike. The spiky scales at the back. So there are some parts that I will not repeat the tutorial to make it. Not to make too much repetition on my channel. So this is how I will work. As you can see, I keep this part darker. Okay. You can see, and then we can do just like that. So this is how we'll do this side. The other side, and I will change the wing because I don't want to. For the other side, these sides, what we are going to do is more or less the same. So, but we are going to. We are not going to go, so, for example, I will do this part here. So, to do this part here, we are going to go first with Calgar blue. Okay. Here is more tricky because it's not showing that much. Now I'm using Smart News, I'm a Crash Blue and Calgar Blue, what I'm using. Okay. Calgar Blue. So what you see, I go lighter to the extremes, leaving the middle part. Lighter in the extremes, giving this part darker. Okay. And then again here, I will try to transition to my grayish blue back. Okay. Let's put a little bit of. Using the Calgar blue here. Right? Then, as we did in the other side, we're going to apply just a little bit of Fenrisian Grey here. Just like that. And we're going to do the same here. This is Calgar Blue. Okay, we'll leave here the model. We're going to apply Calgar Blue here. We'll leave it fade out. Maccragge Blue, who is the darker, to clean up because here I went a little bit with the purple up. And then coming from the other side, Calgar Blue, we'll let it fade out, and a little bit of Fenrisian Grey. Yes, here. And here. Okay. We smooth the transition. And here it's okay to give a sharp blue line. Okay, and now we uniform a little bit the blue. Okay, here, just to be sure that we don't see a real change of thickness. Okay, so this is how we are going to work this side. I'll put a little bit of more. This can be more tricky than what it looks like. Okay, so you see here, this I need to. No, with a beige blue. Okay, so I will. This is how I will be doing all the different parts in the wings. So I will be doing all the wing, and I will be back once this is done. And take into account that these scales, the gold, all the other parts are done like in the rest of the Stardrake. So I will not repeat again here how I do that. So you can go to the parts, the different parts where I explain how to do the scales, how to do the spikes, and how to do the gold. So the highlight on the blues, you see, is done now. Okay, you see here. Really happy with the result, how it's looking like. Okay, and here we have the other wing. Okay, now the wings, this step is done. And the next step we are going to do is I'm going to paint all the scales as I did in one of the previous painting tutorials of this. So I will not do this in that part of the wings. I will just put the camera back once the scales are done. I follow exactly the same technique that I use for the body scales. Okay, you see now that the scales have been done. I also do this, like the back spikes. So I will not go into details how this was done, because it was the same process I did for the rest of the Drake. So I just reapply here the same that we did there. And now I'm going to paint the golden parts, the gold parts, in the same way that I paint the gold on the armor. So I will not explain this part here, neither on the wings. So I will do the gold, and then the final part will be this claws or talons, and I will finalize the wings by explaining that. So I will do the gold, and I will be back. So as you can see now, the gold has been done, and the only thing missing now to finish the work on the wings is this gloves, and also the one at the bottom. So we will do this on camera. The rest is going to be in this is going to be done following the same process. So I will start applying Abbadon Black, okay, as a base color. This is going to be quite similar on how I did the other clothes. Okay, Abbadon Black. Now I'm going to use Ashing Grey. I will use Stormvermin Fur. Let it dry, it is a little big. We go to Downstone Grey. So we are going to use Administratum Grey. Okay. Okay. I'm going to go back to black. This a little bit. Okay, we are going to go a little bit of administrate and going the lighter one here. This is how I will do. I will do the same on the other sides. I will do all the different claws and I will be back once this is done. Okay, I did the nails on the wings and you can see I glued them. I have this to support and to wait until tomorrow that the glue fully have cured. But this is how it looks like. We are going to work later on the joints to make the joints better, but I think I'm very, very happy how the wings look like. This is how the hell look like from the distance. These are the side of the wings, and this is the other wing. There are two positions for the wings in this kit. I went for the ones that the wings are looking much flat. I like this more flat than when it's too vertical. I think I like more this positioning of the wings. So let's see if we can see, the light is not going to be great from the back, but here we see, okay, also the back of the wings. Yeah, the light is not great, but I cannot move. To be fair, I cannot move now the Stardrake. I just put the glue. I try to keep all the parts together
and be sure that everything is going well. So this is how it looks like. This is the Helldrake. The Stardrake is painted at this stage. And the next steps are going to be how to do the saddle, the rider, and the different parts of the rider, like the shield. So I'm going to use him as a Lord Celestan on Stardrake. Very happy. I think I like a lot how the wings turn out at the end. I'm really happy how it's looking like. I think it's a great miniature. It's consuming a lot of time, much longer than what I was expecting. But yeah, I'm quite happy so far. So that's all for now. This is the tutorial on the wings. I hope you have enjoyed that. Remember, in the wings, I just focus on how to do the purple part, the star pattern, this light blue between the membranes of the wing and the nails. The other parts, the gold, the scales, are more or less the same that I did for the other parts. So I did not repeat this in that part of the tutorial. You can go on previous tutorials to see how these parts were done. So that's all for now. I hope you have enjoyed. And keep tuned, because now I will start with the rider, saddle, something with the saddle. I'm going to the rider. So I'll need some more parts to finalize completely this model. But so far, the Stardrake is done. Now we go for the rider. And as usual, if you want to support me, you can comment, like, share, and you can also support me in Patreon. I have a Patreon account where you can support me further. So that's all for now. As usual, thanks a lot for watching, and see you again later. Bye.